Remember, I mean, I'm a foreign correspondent. I work for foreign media, but I'm also Filipino, and I grew up here. And it's heartbreaking for me to see my countrymen suffer this much, because I've had my share of covering these typhoons, and there's been a lot of suffering, obviously. This country has had to suffer so much because of all these natural calamities, but not at this level. And this is not just in Tacloban City. This is everywhere that this typhoon has affected. I mean, we went to northern Cebu, and we were in a van moving, and when we stopped, people, it was just this mob of people who went up to our van. They rushed to our van, and they were just trying to open the door of our van, trying to open the window of our van, just very desperate food and water. I gave them some. Obviously, I didn't have enough. So we ran, and they chased us. They tried to chase us. That's how desperate the situation is, really. 8 or 9 days is a very long time to wait if you've got nothing to eat and nothing to drink. So I do understand the sentiment of these people, but I also do understand that this is very overwhelming for the Filipino government, even though we're used to these disasters. This is a disaster of a whole different level, really.